Hello, Beads friends. In the past, I've made a video when I talked about this tubular beadwork in here, and in that video I said my first idea was not to create this tubular beadwork, but to create a tubular beadwork mixing the right angle weave technique and the peyote stitch technique, and I failed. But you know, failures are one of the most important thing when you work with beads, because by all the failures that you can reach, you will learn so much that no other book, no other beader can teach you. So I'm here because I want to show you my failures, and this is the first sample I try to make. As you can see, I started with a base of 4 beads. I know that maybe if you have no big practice with writing weave technique, it's a little bit hard to see what I'm trying to explain, but I hope you can follow me. I will try to do my best. This is the first round here. You can see 4 beads, bronze, cream, and this is, of course, the right angle weave stitch, okay? My next round was about peyote stitch, because I had this bronze size 11, and I put among all the bronze size 11 some turquoise, size 11 turquoise seed beads. Then I started again with another round of peyote stitch, because I've put this bronze size 11, and then again you can see the right angle weave stitch. The idea is nice, but the final effect not very much, as you can see, because there is no structure and all the beads seems like they are mixed up together, and there is no logic, no design on the tubular beadwork. Another sample I made is this one. Here I have more structure on the beadwork here on the first part, but as for the other one, there is no the colors of the beads has no order, and even if I try to change the colors, the final effect was not good enough. Here I started with the cubic right angle weave technique, the first one, first step, bronze, cream, and then the next round was about peyote stitch, because among all the bronze size 11, I've put turquoise beads. In this case, instead of repeating another step about peyote stitch with the peyote stitch technique, I've decided to go on with the right angle weave. So I started from the turquoise, then bronze, size 15, bronze, size 11, bronze, size 15, bronze. And so on the third round, on the odd round, I've tried to work with the right angle weave technique, and on the even round, I chose a peyote stitch, but here you can see the final effect is not very, very good. So I tried something new again, because I had an idea. I thought that maybe the problem was the base of the beadwork, and so instead of starting with 4 beads, because here you can see there are 4 beads at the base, I started with 6, because I had this idea that maybe changing the number of beads at the base, the structure could be different, and also the position of the bead could be more harmonic in some certain way. But even here, that's a failure, because all the beads are not put very well, and the structure is so soft. You can see here, I can squeeze this tubular beadwork, and that's no good. So these are my failures. I hope you can learn from them, and maybe they can inspire you, because maybe you can find a good solution for mixing peyote stitch and right angle weave stitch on a tubular beadwork. And I hope so. I really hope so. Thank you for watching. Have a nice beading day, and see you soon on the next video. Bye bye.